For a memorial of her. To such a man, and say unto him, that hand. I will keep the Passover at thy house with my disciples.
The disciples did as Jesus had appointed and made ready the Passover. And when evening came, he sat down with the twelve. And as they did eat, he said,
Verily I say unto you, that one of you shall betray.
And give When I drink it new.
Because of thee, yet thy Lord will be never offended.
Jesus said unto him,
Verily I say unto thee, that this night, before the cock crow, thou shalt
thank you. My love for thee affair, my pain.
and he went a little farther, and fell down upon his face, and fled, and said,
"Oh, my father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me, yet not as I will, but as thou wilt." The Savior was before his father kneeling. He raised me and all from Eden's forward, the wondrous grace of God revealing. Prepared he see a cup for death so bitter, bitter drinking, and with the sins of all the burdened harvested, I looked on seeing, for so the loving Father
Oh.
disciples and found them sleeping, and said unto Peter,
What could ye not watch with me awhile? Watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation. The spirit in me is willing, but the flesh is
the chief priests and the elders.
and said,
I be to thee, O master.
Thank you. with Jesus stretched out his hand and smote the high priest's servant and struck his ear off. Then saith Jesus unto him,
O thou that gave my son into his place, for all they that take the sword shall perish with the sword. What thinkest thou that I cannot now pray to my Father, and he shall presently give me more than 12 legions of angels? But how then shall the scriptures be fulfilled, that thus it must be?
In that hour said Jesus to the multitude,
are ye come out as against a thief, with sword and staves for to take me? I sat daily with you, and teaching in the temple, and ye lay no hold on me. But all this was done that the scriptures of the prophets might be fulfilled.
Then all the disciples left him,
high priest called Caiaphas, with whom all the scribes and the elders were assembled. Peter too had followed after him afar off, unto the court of the high priest Annas, and entered in, and sitting among the servants, he waited there that he might see the end. And then the high priests and the elders and the council sought to find false witness against Jesus, that so they might take his life. Yet found they none.
After a little do not know the man.
And immediately the cock crew. Then Peter thought upon the word of Jesus, which said unto him, before the cock croweth, in thou shalt thrice deny me. Then went he out and wept.
betray him. When he saw that he was condemned, repented himself, and brought again the 30 silver pieces unto the chief priests and elders, and said,
Oh, I have sinned, in that I have betrayed innocent blood.
They answered,
What have you done to us? What have you done to us? We don't deserve to die. No, we don't deserve to die.
And he cast down the silver pieces in the temple, and he withdrew and went and hanged himself. Then did the chief priest take the 30 silver pieces and said,
It is not within your power to be injured.
Master. should counsel them together, and what with them the fathers feel for a burial place for strangers. And therefore that field hath been called the Field of Blood, and is so to this day. Then was fulfilled what was spoken by the prophet Jeremiah when he spake, and they took the 30 silver pieces, which was the price of him that was valued, whom they bought of the children of Israel, and in return they gave it for the potter's field. Even as the Lord appointed me. Then did Jesus stand before the governor, and the governor asked him and said,
Art thou the King of the Jews?
Jesus said unto him,
Thou sayest.
And when he was accused of the chief priests and the elders, he answered nothing. Then Pilate said unto him,
Heareth thou not how gravely they accuse thee?
And he answered him to never a word. So that the governor did marvel greatly.
Release unto you Barabbas or Jesus.
descend that he the Christ.
For indeed he knew that for envy they had delivered him. While he was sitting on the judgment seat, his wife sent to him, saying,
"Have thou nothing to do?
Thank you. and cried they out all the more, and said,
"Curse him, Mithro,
thank you. the common hall, and gathered unto him a whole band of soldiers, and stripped him, and put on him a scarlet robe, and painting a crown of thorns, they put it upon his head, and a reed in his right hand. And so they bowed the knee before him, and mocked him, and said,
"We bear thee, we 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 bear thee, son of Jove."
And then they spat on him, and with the reed they smote him on the head.
Thank you.
tasted it, he would not drink. And after they had crucified him, they parted his garments, dividing them by lot, that it might be fulfilled, which was said of old by the prophet. They parted my garments among them, and upon my vesture did they cast lots. And sitting down, they watched him there. And over his head they set up his accusation written, namely, this is Jesus, the King of the Jews. And with him two thieves were crucified, one on the right hand and one on the left. And they that passed by reviled him, both wagging their heads and saying,
"Now that is good, now that is good."
Oh!
and were watching Jesus, when they saw the earthquake and those things that were done, they feared greatly and said,
Thank you. Quod mihi securus in nohau.
They went away, and secured the surface.